So we were discussing about assets, tangible assets and intangible assets. Assets that have a physical existence are called tangible assets, and those assets which doesn't have a physical existence are called what? Rahul.
Sorry.
Assets that doesn't have a physical existence are called?
Intangible
assets. Okay, intangible asset. Okay. Now there is another classification on the basis of operation. It is classified into operating assets and non-operating asset. Operating assets and non-operating asset. It refers to those assets that are useful in the conduct of day-to-day operations of the business. If it is used for the day-to-day operations, daily operations, okay, that is called operating assets. That means those assets which help in the generation of revenue. They help to earn revenue, income. Okay, suppose. Okay, let's say this. Okay, assets that help in the generation of revenue are connected with the core business of the organization. Such assets are called operating asset. Examples of asset include inventory. Inventory, I told you the goods that you deal with, the stock that you deal with. Talking about Max, you have garments there, various products are there. They are the operating assets for them. Okay, it is using that assets that the firm earns its revenue. The income is generated by selling those products. So that is inventory. Inventory means the goods that they deal with. Inventory. Accounts receivable. We'll come to that term. Property. The property. The land, building, etc. So you might be thinking like, this was a fixed asset. Then why are you taking it to operating asset? That is okay. The assets, in total, it is same only. But we are classifying them based on various attributes, various characteristics. Okay. So property, the plant and equipment, even though they are fixed assets only, they are fixed assets. At the same time, they are operating assets too, because they are used for the production. The production in the sense which helps to earn income, revenue. Okay?
Yes,
operating assets. Yes. Okay. Non-operating assets. Sayuji, why are you crying? What happened? Sleepy? Yani? Okay, okay, it's okay. Non-operating assets. These assets are those who are not required in the conduct of daily affairs of the business. They are not required. Okay, examples of such assets includes fixed deposit. We know fixed deposit in the bank, it's fixed over there. Are we using it for the daily operations in the business? No, it's lying fixed in the fixed deposit account in the bank. Okay, that is non-operating asset. Suppose there is a chair in the office room. Okay, there is a furniture, chair, table in the your reception. I mean, in your business, in the reception, there is a sofa set, table, chair and all is there. Are they operating asset or non-operating asset? Yes. Okay. They are non-operating asset. Are they used for the daily operations? I mean, for the production? No, they are the assets. But they are non-operating assets. So asset is clear now. Asset means the property, the things that are, the resources that are owned by the business. The ownership is with the business. And there are various classifications for this business. Mainly keep in mind fixed asset, current asset, tangible asset, intangible asset. Okay? Most importantly, you keep these four heads in your mind. Now, coming to liability. What is liability? Have you heard of liability before? Liability. What is liability? Just a second. So liability are the obligations that the business owes to the outsiders. The business owes to the outsiders. The debt and the obligations that the business has to discharge by paying cash in future. Let me tell you an example. I told you we have a business. It is an ice cream business, ice cream parlor, okay? There is an ice cream parlor. So what is the stock? What is the good I am dealing with? What is Alan smiling? Something is going on. Some discussion is going on there. What happened? You don't like ice cream? Okay, it's an ice cream parlor. So our stock, we deal with ice cream. Okay, I am the owner of the ice cream parlor and I need ice cream to my shop. So I approach Amul. I go to Amul and ask them to give me ice cream. So I am the owner of the firm, owner of the ice cream parlor. I approach Amul and ask them to give me ice cream, sufficient ice cream. And I tell them, see Amul, I cannot give you the full amount now. I will give it later. What is that kind of transaction called? Immediate cash payment is not done. Payment is done in the future. What kind of transaction is that?
Credit.
Credit transaction. So here the business is telling Amul that the payment will be done later. Later. So this is called the liability of the business. For the business, this is liability. The business has to make payment to outsider. Amul is an outsider. Am I right? Yes, Vinay? Are you okay? Clear? Any doubt? So that is called liability. Okay? The fund, if the business owes money to outsiders, if the business take loan from the bank, the business is taking loan from the bank, is that a liability for the business? Yes or no? Yes. The business should repay the loan amount someday in the future. Am I right? So that is a liability. Liabilities are the obligations that the business owes to the outsiders. That is the debt and obligations that the business has to discharge by paying cash in future. Not now, in future. Paying cash in future. Creditors that are created against purchase of goods on credit, loan taken by the business. Okay, and I told you example Amul. Okay, Amul is there and business is there. Business and Amul. Business should make payment to Amul. It is a liability of the business to make payment to Amul. Am I right? So Amul is called creditors, creditor, creditors, the term creditor. Creditors means those to whom the payment has to be done. Am I clear? This is a liability for the business. This is a liability because business is not making payment now. The payment is made only in the future. So this is liability of the business. And coming to this person, who is Amol? Amol is creditor to the business. Amol has given credit. Okay, creditor. Okay, clear the term creditor? The person or the organization or institute or whoever it is, someone to whom the business should make payment to. That is creditors. So, clear liability and creditors? Any doubt? Any clarification required? Please tell me. Okay, now let's understand goods and services. What are goods? What are services? You tell me. Goods and services. First, why these students are not keeping their videos on? Vishnu, Naveen, Aparna, what happened? Okay, tell me, what are goods and services? Anyone, please tell me goods and services. What is the difference between goods and services? Yes, try. Yes, Rose, try. What is good? What is service?
Goods are the products.
Uh-oh, I can't hear you.
They are products.
Once again?
They are products.
Very good. Well, which are products? Goods or service?
Goods.
Goods are products. How about service? Okay, it's okay. Good. You're right. Goods means the things that you see, you can touch. You go to vegetable shop, you buy vegetables. That is a good. An item you can see. You go to a barber shop, you get your hair cut. Are you getting any good from there? But you are paying for it. What is that? That is a service. Okay? You get a taxi. You go travel by auto rickshaw. You move from one place to another. You make payment to the driver. Is there any good involved there? No. But what is there? You get a service. So that is the difference between goods and service. So business, this business will... Business lead, lost the connection. So business is done, is based on both goods as well as service. A business, it is not a mandatory or required that business means only the goods are involved. Business means it involves services also. Beauty parlor, what is that? That is also a business. And what is involved there? Services. We provide services. Am I right? Did you get what is goods and services? Yes. Goods and service. Items you can see and touch that are goods. Services. An action that satisfies our wants through efforts of other people. Other people do something or the other and we are satisfied. That is a service. Hair salon. Law offices. Law. Advocates. Are they providing any goods from there? No. But they are doing some service for us. They are making our cases clear. Restaurants. You are served food. Food is a good. But the service that you get. Okay. So you know the meaning of goods and services now. You understand what is good, what is service. Goods refer to the products that the business entity deals with. The item that the entity purchases and sells in its routine operation. So, coming to a business, if it is a garment shop, what is my good? The garments over there. Okay? If it is a sports shop, what are my goods? The bat, the ball, what else? All those related to the sports. Okay, do you understand what is good? Good means whatever the business deals with. Do you understand? Yes, okay. Give me another example. Supermarket. What are my goods? What am I dealing with? Everything there. The grocery, the soap, shampoo, this masala powders, everything. They are my goods. I deal with those products. That is the goods. Okay. A trading concern who deals with air conditioner. It is an AC showroom. AC selling shop. So what is their good? It is the air conditioners. They sell air conditioners. So their good, that particular business, for them, the good is air conditioner. And at the same time, if someone else is purchasing this air conditioner from that shop, then is it a good for them? Suppose Akshay is having an air condition AC shop. AC, he is selling ACs. Okay, for Akshay, for him, his business, his good is air conditioners. Okay, and Naveen is visiting Akshay's shop and he is buying an air conditioner to his house. So what is this air conditioner for Naveen? Or Naveen is having a business and he is purchasing air conditioner from Akshay's shop. So for Naveen, what is this air conditioner now? Confused?
Service.
Oh my God, no. No, I am asking about air conditioner. Good. Air conditioner is asset. For Naveen, it is an asset. It is not service anyway. Okay, it is not a service. Say, service means this, as I said, the taxi service. Then what else? The hair salons, haircut done. They are not giving you any product. They are satisfying your need. You want to get your haircut done. So they, you visit there. They are cutting your hair. So they are helping you to cut your hair. You go to hospital. You are sick, you go to hospital. Okay, what is being done there? Are they giving you some products? No, they are treating you. They are helping you to be okay, to be fit. They give you medicines, they are treating you. So that is a service. Okay, coming to air conditioner. See, regarding the shop owner, air conditioners are his goods. He is selling air conditioners. But someone who purchased it, for him it is an asset. For Maruti Suzuki, car showroom, what are the cars for them? For them, the cars are their goods. Are you getting the idea? Are you all sleeping? What's the time? 5:07. We have still time. So for Maruti Suzuki, the cars, the vehicles, what are that for them? Are they assets? Are they assets? No. Because they are dealing with cars. They are selling the cars. For them, the cars are their goods. Okay. And the one, Rahul is going to buy a car from there for his personal use. So for Rahul, is it a good?
No.
No, for him, it is an asset. He gave money and he is using the car. So for Rahul, it becomes his asset. Clear now? Okay. Now, coming to the next term, sales. See, sales. Sales means what? Sales. That means exchanging the goods. For what? For money. You sell something and you get money. That is called sales. Sales refer to the supply of goods and service by the business to the customers from which the income is generated. Okay, this sales can be provided either in cash or on credit. So you know what is credit now? Don't you know what is credit now? So sales means what? I have so much of vegetables. I am growing vegetables at home. So I decided to sell the vegetables. Okay? So you all are coming to me to purchase my vegetables. So what is happening there? You people give me money, I give my vegetables to you. That is called sales. For money, we exchange the products. We give the goods for money. Is it clear? That is sales. Okay? And this sales, if suppose Sayuji is telling me, I don't have money now, I'll give you tomorrow. That means what kind of a transaction is that?
Credit.
Credit transaction. So this sales, it can be either on cash or credit. You got the answer? You got the meaning?
Yes, ma'am.
The sales, it can be for cash. Cash means directly, immediate payment of cash is taking place. If it is credit, sales can be made either for cash or for credit. Credit means payment is not done immediately, but on a future date. Okay, no?
Yes,
now, coming to revenue. What is revenue? These are all accounting terms. We are discussing various terms that we are going to be used, that we are going to use in future. Revenue. Revenue means the income that I get from the sale of the goods. Goods means whatever the business deals with. I told you, I am doing a vegetable business. That means my good is vegetable. For Maruti Suzuki, their good is the vehicles, the cars. Okay. For a supermarket, their good is the products over there. For Kalyan Silks, what is their good? Their good is the sari, the garments over there. You understand what is good? Yes. Okay. Now, when this good is sold, when you sell the good, what you get in return? That is called revenue. Okay? Revenue. It is, you cannot call it as income. Okay? It is revenue. The term used is revenue. Revenue is the income. It is income only. The income earned from the sale of goods and services during the normal course of business or from other activity is called revenue. Now, expenses. What are expenses? What are expenses? Tell me, what are expenses?
Money needed for the daily purpose.
Once again.
Money for the daily purpose.
Money for daily purpose, not for money for daily purposes. For purpose. See, for the business, what you spent. See, I told you I have a vegetable. I'm growing vegetables. Okay, and I'm selling vegetables. For me, the expenses, all those related to growing of that vegetables. I need to buy fertilizers. I need to buy manures, soil, all those related to that particular business. That is called expenses. Expenses related to the business operations. That is called expenses. Expenses refer to the cost incurred by the business during the normal course of business operations to generate revenue. When the business is trying to make revenue, what are the costs involved? For example, salary payable. I have a bakery. I am having a bakery business. So for bakery business, I have so many staff to cook. So, there is a people to make jalebi, there are people to make laddu, there are people to make cakes. So my business, what are my goods there? A bakery business, what is the goods there? My goods are these sweets and all those things. The cake, the sweets, whatever. That is a good for bakery. To make this goods, okay? The cost I incur, I have cook to prepare all this. For that cook, I need to pay wages. I have appointed an accountant in my bakery to do the accounting. Accountant is there. So I should pay salary to the accountant. I have taken the room for the bakery for rent. So I should pay rent for this bakery room. I mean that shop. So that rent, these are all the expenses. Okay? Aparna, dull, tired of listening to me? It's okay. I understand. Okay, that is expenses. So should we stop with this?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, this is enough, I think.
More than enough.
I am not winding up the session. Oh, no need. Okay. So, the terms are clear? So, just recollect the terms that we studied today. We discussed transaction, then asset, capital. We discussed about capital. You have all these terms in the textbook. Learn and come. Next day, I'll ask questions. These are all very important terms. Capital, asset, liability, then goods and service. Then what else? Revenue, sales, expenses. Okay? Clear to everyone? Okay.